Hello everyone! So I just filmed my May favorites, and of course the next thing to come along with that is my May empties. I always, at the very beginning of the month, I'm always like, oh no, I totally don't think I'm going to finish enough products for like a worthy video, and then I'm so stoked and surprised at the end of the month when I see how much stuff I've used up. So I absolutely love these videos, as I say in every video. So I'll go ahead and show you guys what I used up. As usual, cotton rounds, Costco, love them. I used up this LA Fresh Travel Light. I got them in a subscription. They're the makeup remover wipes. Did not like these. There was 8 of them. They were super, super tiny. So you really need probably 2 of them to get your whole face done. But they did burn my skin, so wasn't a fan, but glad that I used them up. The next are the Yes 2 Blueberries. These are the brightening facial towelettes. I will say the actual little wipes are very large and durable. They don't kind of fall apart on you. But still was not in love with them. They kind of irritate my skin. I think just the Yes 2 brand itself is just not a good mix for my skin. I have very sensitive skin. A bath experience here. This is the Village Naturals Therapy Stress and Tension Relief Foaming Bath Oil. Matt got this for me on Christmas and he got me several of them. I finally finished this one up, and this one's really just kind of potent, and this has juniper and menthol. Definitely can smell the menthol. I love it. Definitely gives a nice blue look to your water. Plus it's really great at bubbling up. Got a little left in there. Of course that always happens, huh? But I really just think it is really great. I really liked it. So I would definitely suggest it and purchase it again. We've got the Fresh Pick Tangerines hand soap. Love these soaps. Do love this scent. I would get this one again. We've got the Bali Mango by Bath & Body Works. This one I think has been one of my favorite scents. It is so like in your face, tropical and fruity, and just amazing. I think this is definitely one of my favorites. Next product is this e.l.f. Lotion Wipes. This is in vanilla and coconut. I've talked about these in a favorites before. These are awesome. I absolutely love them. They're great. One little wipe will actually do your entire body and give you a really light moisture to your skin. This is really great to me if you're gonna put clothes on right on and you don't want to have too thick of a lotion on, as well as like putting in your purse or traveling with. I just opened a new one actually. It's like the mango one, and I have noticed that, I don't know if it's just the different flavors or if this was because this was when they first came out, but the mango ones are a lot. The wipes are actually not as durable and they fall apart a little bit more. I still can get one wipe for my whole body and I still really like them, but I did notice that. So if you guys have noticed that, let me know if it's like the newer brands or this flavor, what's going on. This was awesome. This was the Body by Avon Naturals Chocolate Ice Cream Scrub. This smelled so good. This was a very, very gentle exfoliating. You really had to get in there to really feel like the granules or whatever. This is by Lush. Finally finished this up. This was the Angels on Bare Skin All Natural Facial Scrub for normal and dry skin types. This had a really cool kind of natural scent to it, and it had a little kind of, I think they were like some sort of nut, I think, in there too, where it had the tiny little exfoliators. This was very creamy. I used it in the shower. Made my feel really nice. Again, something that had a little bit of an exfoliation to it, but nothing too harsh where you could use it every day and it felt good using every day. So I definitely suggest this if you have sensitive skin. And it definitely was nice for dry skin too, because it was very like thick and creamy and just nice. Used up another one of my e.l.f. Nail Polish Remover Pads. I really like these. They come with 18. I can get usually, depending on the polish, but one wipe will either take off all my polish or one per hand. I just think they're great. I have no issues with them, and they're only a dollar. Then I've got this Hydrating Macadamia Oil by Organics. and this is the dry styling oil. This lasted a really long time. I do alternate products though, but I think it's great just to kind of give your, you know, hair a little bit of oomph. If you do use too much, it will make your hair oily, even for someone who has dry hair like me. But if you use a good amount, just the perfect amount, it does, you know, do a really great job kind of moisturizing your hair. And I would definitely repurchase it again. I've got a bunch of things to use at first, but I thought it was good. These products I didn't actually use up all the way. This is the Ulta Color Instinct Shade Adjusting Foundation in Light. I found another Ulta product several months ago. I had to get rid of several Ulta foundations because I kind of figured out that something in them breaks me out. I tried this one, did the same thing, so I had to get rid of it. So I can't really say anything other than that, but I think it did do the whole kind of adjusting to your color. And so yeah, I mean, that was okay for that, but not good for my skin. This is the Youngblood Mineral Primer, and this one, I don't know, you guys will have to tell me if you've tried this. Smells so gross. It smells like fish or something like that, or rancid. Smells super gross, so I just was like, nah, shouldn't use this on my face. I don't know if I have a bad one. This was a sample. I don't know if it's bad. I don't know if that's just the scent. Either way, it's going away. This is the Vichy Eyes Anti-Wrinkle and Firming Care Eye Cream. This was not too like intense on your eyes, like it didn't burn or anything like that, but like it was so bizarre. It made the very I don't know, like that skin right underneath your lashes super dry. And I know it was this because as soon as I changed to another eye cream, when I finished this up, it completely healed up like immediately. So that was very bizarre, so I would not suggest it and won't ever use it again. This is the Juice Beauty Green Apple Moisturizer. Got this in an Ipsy. This smells amazing. Like straight up apple fruit deliciousness. So good. I was loved every second of it when I used it during the day. This is a day cream. Loved it. Has SPF in it, so that was always really good. This says that it's a light, I think it says something on lightweight moisturizer. I will say that it didn't feel super, super heavy, but to me it wasn't lightweight. It had a very thick consistency where you really had to actually kind of work it into your skin to get rid of like the white lotion look. And you definitely knew it was on there. So I would say this was actually a heavier cream in my opinion, but I thought it was nice. It moisturized it. I felt like it was protecting my skin, as well as the scent was amazing, and it kind of like lasted for a while. Next product is by Philosophy. This is the Soul Owner Exfoliating Foot Cream. This, when you think exfoliating, you think it's gonna have some sort of little bead or something like in there to kind of exfoliate. No. So I don't really know what's in it that supposedly exfoliates. This smelled so gross to me. I don't know what it is about Philosophy's products, but it just was not right. I just wasn't feeling it. That's just my personal preference again. So I didn't think that it did miracles. I didn't like the scent. I was so happy to be done with it. So that's my impression of that. One that I did love the scent to was the Julep, the best petty cream ever. This, I really liked. I did think that it moisturized. I don't know if it was anything better than like just a regular lotion to put on your feet, but the scent was fantastic. This was, I think it says cucumber. Yeah, it has little cucumbers on there. And to me, it smells straight up cucumber, but not like artificial cucumber. It smells like I just took a cucumber, a fresh cucumber, and cut it up in that scent that that gives you, which I love. I'm obsessed with cucumbers, so I thought this was fantastic. I just absolutely adored the scent, so I would consider repurchasing this. I think mostly for the scent, and I think it did a good job moisturizing too. So I'll look into this one, see how much it is. I think we're, oh, three more. Oh my goodness, three more products. So this one I loved. This was by Philosophy. This is Take a Deep Breath, and it's their oil-free energizing oxygen gel cream moisturizer. This didn't have an offensive scent, which I guess I've been having issues with Philosophy face products and body products. I thought thought this was really like cooling. It like felt cool on my face and it just was so nice and light and moisturizing, and it really was a fantastic moisturizer. So I am totally looking into this once I've used a bunch of more of my little samples like this, because this would totally be one that I would repurchase in the larger size. Two last makeup items. This is the Boscia, I don't know how to say it, BB cream, and this is the self-adjusting shade for all skin types. I really liked this. I was using it several times. I think I have another one or two of these from different samples laying around somewhere. I definitely thought it was nice. I think it gave great coverage. It comes out really, really dark, and so I was a little nervous about that with my skin color, but it definitely does adjust and gave a nice finish to my skin. I noticed that you can't layer this with other like tinted products, because I had one moisturizer that's like hardly any tint but has a little baby tint to it, and when I put this on top to try to make like a heavier coverage BB cream, it totally made my skin like that super dark color. So you can't layer it with other anything colored, but primers were fine. So I thought this was great. I'll use up my other samples and kind of see if maybe I'll repurchase it. It's a possibility, depending on how much it is. I don't know how expensive it is. And then this is, last but not least, my Maybelline Lash Stiletto. This is actually in brownish black, which was kind of a nice fun change. This I thought was a cool kind of funky wand. I think it gave a nice dark mascara look to my eyelashes, but nothing too dark. So it was that kind of more natural but still pigmented eyelash look. I did notice that once this was getting a little bit older, it was really, really flaky. So I didn't like that. Basically after like the first month, I started noticing that it was getting really flaky. But other than that, I liked the color. I thought that was kind of fun, trying a little bit different color of mascara instead of just black, black, black. So yeah, so those are my thoughts. And I think those are all of my empties. I had a ton, so I tried to ramble through these fast. But let me know if you guys have finished any of these products. Put the thumbs up if you like these empty videos. I love them, as you all know. And subscribe so that you can continue watching my videos. And I will see you in one of my next ones. Bye.